All right, Fireside Chat, Pastor Flammy here, who gave a presentation on the three uses of reason from Gerhard. Don't the Lutherans hate reason?
The Lutherans do not hate reason. It's a gift that comes from God, and Luther talks about it in the first article of the Creed in his explanation, in fact.
Didn't Luther call reason a whore?
Yes, indeed he did. When whore... I can't do these videos, man.
You're right. No, I can't cut it. It's live. We can't stop it.
This is live?
Yeah.
All right.
No,
reason is a whore when reason tries to shut Jesus up and speak over him.
Didn't Gerhard disagree with Luther? Luther hated reason, but Gerhard loved it.
No, Gerhard and Luther actually agreed, and Gerhard would quote Luther concerning his disparaging remarks about reason when reason wanted to say things contrary to the Holy Scriptures.
So Gerhard says there's three uses of reason. There's a inductive, what was it? What, the I one?
Give me the microphone.
Oh, I'm asking the questions here. A constructive, destructive,
Instrumental.
So tell us about the instrumental use of reason.
Reason is used as an instrument to read and to understand the Holy Scriptures. You need to know something about the language of Greek and Hebrew and Aramaic. You need to know something about grammar and syntax, and also the definitions of words. Now, all of this is necessary to engage with the scriptural text, which gives us the Word of God in human language. And so insofar as we perfect our skills with regard to grammar, logic, and rhetoric, we are helping reason to serve as a handmaiden to the Holy Scriptures.
Gerhard, in this context, says that reason is a slave to the Scriptures and a slave to God. Is that right?
Yes, that's absolutely correct. The moment and the second that reason desires to assert something over and against what the Scriptures claim, so, for instance, that God cannot possibly be one in essence and three in person, then Gerhard says reason must be bound and enslaved to the greater wisdom of God revealed in the Holy Scriptures.
What about the constructive use of reason? What does that mean?
The constructive use of reason is that there are some things that we know from human reason and the powers that belong to our senses and our rational processes, such as that God exists, that God is all-powerful, that there is such a thing as good and evil. These things all belong to reason and sense. And we can come up with good philosophical arguments that confirm what is already revealed to us in the Holy Scriptures. Again, these arguments can be helpful, but they should never replace or displace the testimony of the Holy Scriptures. Instead, we present them to our opponents to say, hey, look, if you want to use reason, these are the conclusions you also must come to.
And the destructive use of reason.
Yeah, the destructive use of reason is also called the apologetic use of reason. This is taking up the arguments of the opponents, finding the logical and philosophical inconsistencies in these arguments, and then showing them that they don't have anything to stand on, at least rationally or philosophically. Gerhard says that these arguments must be used sparingly, since we cannot ourselves build up our own position on the premises of logic, reason, philosophy. Instead, we use this kind of argumentation insofar as it's helpful to draw people into the testimony of the Holy Scriptures.
And all three uses are under the Scripture.
Yes, all three uses are under the Scripture. And as soon as any one of those uses of reason tries to displace or tries to speak over the testimony of the Holy Scriptures with regard to the majesty of God and the Holy Trinity, how it's possible that God can be flesh in the person of Christ, then reason has to be silent there and bound and enslaved, just as you said.
Last question. What do you think about this goatee I'm growing?
I can't even see it.